Evening everybody, Rich here, back for another video. Something a bit different to what I normally do. This is one of those train journey videos. I've already done a couple of these already, but nothing really explained. But what we're doing today, we're going to take a train ride from Oshawa in Canada all the way to Buffalo in New York. It's basically a scaled down map, which I got off the Steam Workshop. It's quite well detailed. Basically, we'll run the train, or rather train route from Oshawa up here on the top, runs along the coast of Lake Buffalo through Toronto, Oakville, Hamilton, St. Catharines, and all the way to Buffalo alongside along Niagara Falls down here. So it's probably going to be about half an hour journey, but hopefully it won't be that long, but we'll see. So what we're going to do, we're going to fly down to the station, and our train is just pulling in, which is bloody convenient. This is the train we're going to be taking. And the top speed of this thing is around 62 miles an hour, but I don't think we'll get anywhere near the top speed of it, so it's going to be a little while. Even on the downhill sections, it's going to struggle for speed. So this is just pulling in now. And our offload, got 155 grand for that. So what we do now, climb aboard, and this is the view we will have. So we're at Oshawa at the moment, and I think the next stop is Scarborough, so we're on our way now. And this goes all the way to Buffalo in New York, so it basically goes across the border. So, yeah, this is something a bit different. I thought I'd talk along the way, because I know a lot of people get bored with some of the video, well, say the other two videos. It's basically just watching a train going, so I thought I'd have a little chat while we go along. Seems pretty fast, but only going 17 miles an hour. And I've just dropped something on the floor, which really doesn't help. Hello, Mr. Bus. Empty bus. A pink bus as well. Never mind. So it looks like we've got a clear track all the way as well. So there's no stacking by the looks of it all the way to our destination. There are a few other trains on the journey. Most of them are going the same way, but there are some trains which will spur off to the right and go in their own. Their own separate direction, off to the east. Is it east? Yeah, off to the east, and they'll be out of the way. There's no freight services on this line either, so we're not going to be held up, and we're not going to be pushing trains along. So it should be a clear route. Now we're just coming up to where the track doubles back. So basically, the station we just left is a roll-on, roll-off station, so you come in the back and leave through the front. So this track here, on the right here, so basically it spurs off and it doubles back and it loops back onto where we are, so that's how it works. Here comes another train. This is one of the one that usually spurs off. No, it's not. It's actually the same route we're taking. And I've really got to sort these level crossings out because they are a bit bumpy. So that's a train just returning from Buffalo. And there's quite a lot of steep hills on this journey as well, so we're not gonna be flying along today. And we're coming up to probably the tightest corner on the route as well. This is something that's gonna have to be changed at a later date. I'm gonna have to try and straight line this corner a bit more because it is a really tight corner. It goes across the road, and there is a sheer cliff to the left, as you can see, there's quite a steep cliff to the side. I put trees around it to try and hide it, but it is a very steep cliff. And that is a very noisy train by the side of us. There's another train coming as well. There's quite a few trains coming back. So that's one of the spur trains. That one spurs off to the east. And I may as well shut up for a minute. That's not it. Just over to the left, that turquoise building, I think that's the dock, because we've got a ship running as well. It goes from one side of the lake to the other. It's not very economical, it doesn't earn us any money. And just got a massive lag spike there. Come on, game, speed up. There we go. Yeah, the ship doesn't really earn any money, so it's the trains do the job. The trains take a bit longer, but because the train has to go right round the map rather than across it, so but the trains do the better job. So now we're just pulling up to Scarborough. Wave to the people on the side. And there are quite a few people waiting here. car going across the crossing there. So that's our first stop. In Scarborough. They're off to Toronto. I was getting worried and I thought that bloke right walking there wasn't going to stop, but luckily he had common sense. And that bloke as well. It's not like Grand Theft Auto where they just walk out in front here and go splat. There comes another return journey train. And that house is a bit close to the track, if I must have must point out. And just going across the first river as well. This bridge is a bit dodgy as well. There seems to be a graphical glitch with this bridge, so I'm gonna have to try and demolish it and rebuild it and sort of see the walls are missing. So that's something that needs to be fixed. Never mind. And it's only a short spur to Toronto. I think it's only a short spur. And then we'll fly a bit longer. That's another tight corner to the right as we cross the road. It's only 1904, but a lot of people have got cars already. And here's our next destination, Toronto. Quite a big city, this one. I had to build the station right through the middle of it, which didn't please a lot of people. I think it was this city I sort of half destroyed just to put a station in the middle. So either this one or one a bit further along, I'm not really sure, but judging by the amount of houses on both sides, I think it was this town, or city now. I think we're going to hit a full load here, there's quite a few people waiting. Toronto. And now heading for Oakville. Sound effects seem to be having a bit of a problem. Quite a busy line, as you can tell, just by the amount of trains. I mean, we've had four trains on the other side since we've been in Toronto, so you can really see how busy this line is. Yeah, the sound effects are struggling at the moment. I don't know what's going on. See, another train. There's a really busy line. That's another one of those spur... not spur, is it excursion lines. And another one in the distance. And across the river again. Or a different river, rather. Quite a big town in the distance, you can see all those houses, so there's going to be quite a few people waiting there, I expect. We're only travelling 35 miles an hour. I mean, this locomotive is a top speed of 62, and the carriages it's pulling are a top speed of 62, but we're not getting, I don't think we're getting near that. And there's the spur, or the excursion line. That's where a couple of the trains come from, so the amount of trains we'll see along the route now will be a little reduced. And there's a set of buffers there for some reason, don't know why I put them there. And just as I say, trains be reduced, there's one coming now. There should be one more stop along this side of the lake, and then we cross the estuary and then we should be up to Hamilton there. Nice cliffs in the distance. Really like the scenery on this game. Of course, if you didn't know the title, it's Transport Fever, but I may not have said that. Yeah, just jump straight to the video, but never mind. Cross another bridge, pass another train, and we shall be approaching Oakville. Quite a few people wait, not as many as the previous stop. The station's only on the edge of the town as well, so there's not going to be as big a demand for the train. But if you look across the lake, you can see a few trains in the distance. There's one over the far left, and there's one almost directly in front of us. So they're just coming across. The lake estuary. So that's where our next port of call. Because Stony Creek, Stony Creek is on the other side of the lake estuary. So we're going to cross that. There'll be a turn to the left, or turn to the right by the looks of it first, and then turn to the left. It's a shame we can't move the camera around. I would like to see some of the scenery to our side, but hey ho, never mind. Just to see, I'm really interested to see what's behind this, because I mean, the amount of trains on the other line, it makes me wonder if we're not causing a traffic jam. But I don't think that is the case. So nice cliff design. Nice cliff detailing on the right there. I think there's a road up there, I think that's why it's so steep. So hopefully now the train will be able to stretch its legs a bit more, should get to some decent speed. Across the bridge. I really should have built these bridges a bit higher to allow ships to pass, but it's not a big issue. Ships aren't really that economical at the moment. So maybe something for the future. Ooh, grass growing there. I really ought to keep tab of how many trains are passing. I mean, there's a huge amount of trains on this line. actually see how deep that lake is as well. There's a sheer cliff down to the lake bed. Now we're just on the south side of the lake. Now heading east. I think it's east, isn't it? We're heading west. Now we're heading east. And just approaching Stony Creek. Should be quite a few passengers for this one, because there is a bus connection for this station, so a lot of people from neighbouring towns are using the buses to get to the station for further travel. So you're never going to be late for a train on this route, you're just going to be early for the next one. That's Stony Creek. What's our next port of call? St. Catharines, that's our next stop. Gonna pass a few towns before we get there, I think. Turkey. Once again, the sound effects are struggling. Excuse me. Nice bit of landscape here, isn't it? Nice bit of bare land. Useful for farmland or whatever. Or just more space to build stuff. And the train. Yeah, like I said, this train is really struggling for speed. Even though it's the top speed available is 62, it just seems to cruise along at a steady 35, 36. I think even on the downhill bits it may struggle. Another river. Another train approaching. I mean, you just really should write down how many trains we passed. There's an awful lot on this route. The bridge to cross, and I think that is St. Catharines we are approaching now. We're turning. Yeah, it is St. Catharines. It is the next stop. We're just turning a sharp right and a sharp left. Then we'll be in St. Catharines. And I think this is another bus drop-off point. I think there are buses from the neighbouring towns. See up on the right there, just behind the station building, you see a road going up the hill there. I think that's where the town is, just in the distance. I think it's this state, it's this this area. There's a couple of towns and villages over the top of the hill. And there are bus routes connecting that. So that's St. Catherine's. Next stop is Buffalo, our final destination. Now this is where the route gets a bit more interesting. It's going to be a steep climb up alongside Niagara Falls, or at least where Niagara Falls would be, and then it drops downhill again the other side as it pulls into Buffalo. And this is quite a neat looking route. I see, so at least the way the things I built, I try to build things, try to make them pretty, but I think it looks pretty good. You can see that train there in front of us has just come down the hill. Now we're going to go up it. So the line will sort of zigzag up gradually, and then it'll run along the side of the side of a hill. That road needs straightening out as well. Look at it, drops down and curves up and drops down again. Railways and road really don't mix. So this is going to be a steep climb. We're going to drop a lot of speed going up here. We're not doing too bad at 24, 25, oh, going up speed. Oh, now I drop it. This really need every ounce of horsepower. You got a nice view over the looking over the valley below. Got a road, river, plenty of trees, lots of scenery down there. And I just hope the next generation of engines can pull trains much faster up this incline. It is quite a steep bit. I really should have planned it out a bit more, but anyway, never mind. But the next generation of track and train should make this a doddle. Then we're going to start going downhill. Just over in the distance is where Niagara Falls would be. Of course, you can't really scale it in this game, but that's where it would be. And now we're going to go downhill and then pull into Buffalo somewhere in the distance. This is the last bridge. Now Now, in theory, the line should split up ahead. Built a track on the right, we'll divert away from the track on the right, and we'll do a spurt around. Oh no, there's another bridge coming. Yeah, the track will do a loop round. And we'll enter the station. Lag spike. I haven't been down this end of the map for quite a while, so I think the town has actually grown quite a bit. And I think it's grown around the station quite a bit, so progress is quite good. So now we're just pulling, spurring around, across the crossing, sharp right, and then we'll be into the station. That'd be the journey for today done. Nice rolling hills in the background, or not rolling hills, but nice green hills in the distance. Very picturesque. Another turkey for some reason. The sound ruined by the clatter of aging wagons. And we pull into Buffalo, and there's our final destination. That's our journey for today. Plenty of people waiting, plenty of people want to go home, plenty of people want to go to work. And then we pull into the station. And that is our trip. And then we can exit that, and there's our train. We'll earn $339,000 for that trip. And that's our journey. That's from Oshawa to Buffalo. Hope you enjoyed all that, and what we'll do, we'll just sit here and watch our train depart. Nice shiny chrome on that engine there. Compliments to the developers of this game, they put a lot of hard work into this, and I really appreciate it. That looks fantastic. So we'll just sit and wait for our train to disappear. I say disappear, just pull away. How many passengers has he got? He's got 58 passengers, so he's nowhere near fully loaded, but it'll turn a good profit nonetheless. And there's a train behind us just pulling in there, or will pull in just a second. So there we go, there's our train leaving the station. Let's have a fly around. So there's an aerial view, so there's where we are, an aerial view of Buffalo. The town has actually grown quite a bit since I started playing this map, about an hour or two ago. So yeah, progress is at hand. There's a Niagara, where Niagara Falls would be, but hey, never mind. And here's that area where the train's up in the hill and the road down here. It does really look good. You look up and see that train in the distance. And that engine, I think that train should have been the one we should have been on, because that one's got a lot more power. As you can see, he was doing 40 miles an hour until he started going downhill. So that engine's got more power, so that really is the one we should have been on, but never mind. You can really see, you can't really see where the trees are, but you can see the incline, how steep it is. But, never mind. There's another train coming there. Plenty of people waiting at the station now, plenty of people wanting to go home, so we've got 91 people waiting. Plenty more people waiting along the route, so there's not enough trains really for the route, but never mind. So we'll just do another aerial view of where we were. So basically you can see, we started over here in Oshawa, train runs all the way along to the east, then heads west, heads south, and then heads east. I think that's the way, isn't it? West, south, east, well, whichever way you want to look at it. So that's where we'd done. And compliments to the person who put the map together as well. It's on the Steam Workshop. We want to go and download. I can't remember what it's called, but it's probably Buffalo or something like that. So you can trace it and download it. It's quite good. And I think it's in the process of being updated as well. Here's our dock. And no, nothing waiting. There's one person waiting, so that makes the ship ever the more needed. And there's the ship paddle steamer just pulling into the dock here. You've got seven people waiting here. And there are three people on board. Let's see how much of a profit he makes. If he ever pulls it out. $2,000. So he's not really making a huge amount of money, but never mind. That's quite a neat paddle steamer as well, isn't it? If I could build that in Minecraft, I would. And a whistle as well. So yeah, if I could build that in Minecraft, I would. But never mind. Anyway, that is our trip from Buffalo. No, from Oshawa to Buffalo. And we've got a bit of a queue forming here. But yeah, so that's our trip for today. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. And hope to make another video soon. So this is Rich signing off, logging off and disappearing. And I shall return with another video. So bye for now.